So in the last episode dedicated to how to speed up the use of Twinmotion. Today, we close the circle with, of course, the media. In case you missed the first two episodes, I leave you the link of both in the description. As far as I'm concerned, no matter what kind of media I'm going to create, the starting point will always be an image. So I opened the media and created it right away. At this point, the next thing I do is immediately choose the rendering engine to use. And, with rare exception, I set the Lumen engine, without changing any parameters in the engine settings. Before changing any values, I activate the view set with the lights off created in the previous episode, update the media, and all in all, intervene on the ambience. I set the camera, the environment, and the last, the effects. When the preview is ready, I start the testing phase where I normally use a little heavy form, such as Full HD, to rendering speed. From the result, I decide what to change in the media, and then make new tests again and again, until the image satisfies me. Rendering with Lumen Engine with default parameters allows me to render in very few seconds all the test images I need, and in a few minutes I will have the final image ready to be rendered with the maximum Lumen reflection settings and with a higher format. Normally, I render in 4K resolution. At this point, as the scene lighting is working perfectly with only natural light, I duplicate the image and activate the view set with the artificial light intended for the Lumen engine, also creating the previous video. It is at this precise moment that I finally modify the parameters of the artificial lights, adapting them to the view I have just set up. In case I need more light, I could always activate the area light container, update the media, and adapt the light parameters to the scene. If I changed the artificial lights before even setting the ambient parameters, I would definitely have to change them again after setting the ambience, thus losing time. Remember that unless a room has no windows or the render is developed at night, it is not the artificial lights that illuminate the scene. The render should work well even without artificial light. These are just a plus that we add to increase the detail and the final quality. I'd like to take just 20 seconds, I promise, to inform you that I'm creating the Twinmotion Masterclass Learning Portal, where I will guide you through the fantastic world of Twinmotion, whether you're a beginner or an expert. Click on the link in the description of this video to stay updated on all the news and secure an exclusive discount at launch. Pre-register now using your email. Thank you so much for the support and enjoy the video. If, however, you could use the PathTracer engine, then at this point, duplicate the first image you create, the one without the lights, and turn on the PathTracer. The ambient settings will be almost the same as the ones you set a moment ago, so I immediately start the first test. In this case, I set the quality to medium, use a lightweight format such as Full HD, and start the render. The medium quality of the PathTracer will generate a render in a very few seconds and will allow you to tell right away if the natural light is working or if there is something to change. As with the Lumen engine, I now tweak the ambient settings and run a series of tests until I get a satisfactory result. In case your hardware is performing well, you could run the tests in high mode, but in any case the image quality will be low. Right now, the only important thing is to see how the overall lighting behaves, while reflections, materials and finishes are all details that will be brought out as soon as you start the final high quality render. When the test phase is over, as with the Lumen engine, I duplicate the media in PathTracer and activate the view set with the artificial lights intended for the PathTracer engine. Change the light settings to my taste and finish with the last test run. As far as I'm concerned, view sets are critical not so much to speed up the use of Twinmotion, but to avoid, again, wasting time at a later stage. Once the image creation phase is finished, you have completed 90% of the work, regardless of the media you create. If the need will be to create a video, I recommend that you first enter the Lumen engine image media mode and all in all create the first frame of the video. By doing so, the new video you create will have the exact same environment settings as the image you created a moment ago, and all you will have to do is create new frames for your video, without having to change any more settings. Of course, The same concept applies to any other media, under any other circumstance, and with all rendering engines. I hope this three-part series on how to speed up, or if you prefer, how to avoid wasting time using Twinmotion, has been useful. I remind you that I'm always available and open to discussion. So please, write in the comment which topic you would like me to analyze in the next video. That said, for the last time of this series, thank you again for your support and see you very, very soon. Ciao!